In this video, I'm explaining how to model working locomotive beacons, starting with the beacon model itself, how to illuminate the beacon, and how to wire everything to make it work. So let's get started. Let's talk about the beacon model itself. I'm using 3D printed models from a Shapeways shop. I've linked the N-scale models I've used so far below. What's important here is that whatever model you're using, it has to be printed in fine detail plastic. The material is somewhat translucent, so we can mount an SMD LED underneath the beacon to illuminate it. Before starting to paint the beacon, I mount the beacon model to the cap roof, and since I want to illuminate the beacon later, I need to drill a hole for the LED first. That hole also helps when positioning the beacon on the cap roof. Beacons are typically mounted dead center on the cap, and in order to get everything properly centered, I line up the headlights, the drill bit, and the centers of the roof fans while looking down the length of the roof. I remove the light conductor for the front light before I start drilling the hole. I use a smaller 0.8mm drill bit first and then make the hole bigger with a 1mm drill bit. That leaves me with wiggle room to make corrections in case I didn't make the first hole quite in the center of the cap. Then I test fit the LED and make modifications as necessary to get a good fit. The LED is rectangular, so I make the hole slightly elongated to keep the hole as small as possible. It's also important to leave a bit of a gap between the front of the cap and the beacon so the beacon LED has no direct contact to the light conductor for the headlight. This will make the light conductor installation easier and also reduces the risk of light leaking from the beacon to the headlight. I'm using pre-wired LEDs in the 0603 housing with a light output of 400 MCD. This is smaller and not as bright as the LEDs I'm using for headlights. When selecting the LEDs, make sure to not get a device that's too bright. You can dial down the brightness in most decoders, but that often deteriorates the function effect when you have to dial down the brightness too much, so you want to be in the right ballpark to begin with. When I'm gluing the beacon to the cap roof with superglue, I'm using the headlights and roof vents as a sight to make sure it's properly centered. Before I glue the LED, I remove the cap from the shell if possible. That makes it a lot easier to get the LED in the correct position. When gluing the LED in place, I simply apply a bit of superglue and then push the LED into the hole underneath the beacon. When the glue has dried, I paint the inside of the cap roof to reduce the amount of light entering the cap. After reassembling the shell, it's time to wire up the LED. Putting a connector in between the decoder and the LED is useful if you need to remove the shell, so I recommend using one if there is enough room. I tape the LED wire to the roof of the shell with Captain tape to keep it in place and to avoid short circuits with other components. Don't forget the resistor when connecting the LED to the function output. Now it's time to paint the beacon. I apply at least two layers of black to the base in order to prevent light leak between the beacon and the roof as well as through the beacon base. If you're modeling a road that doesn't happen to have black cap roofs, you might want to consider painting the first layers in the actual roof color so don't have to be super precise with every single layer. I'm using Tamiya XF16 aluminium for the beacon base. Usually, one layer of the aluminium paint is enough. Since I'm going to weather this engine eventually, I'm not too worried about covering the black base layer perfectly. The beacon top is painted with Tamiya X26 transparent orange. This color usually requires two or three applications for an even finish. I wait at least a couple of hours between the layers of the orange paint. It takes longer than the other colors to dry, and disturbing it during the drying process can cause it to come off the model as a gooey film. I activate the beacon LED to quickly check the paint application between the layers and make corrections as required. Here's a shot of the finished engine on the layer. I used a model for the Stratolite, so I programmed the decoder to use the Stratolite effect instead of a rotary beacon effect for the function output. Some decoders have programmable timing for the effect. I like to use slightly different timings on my engines so that they don't all flash in the exact same moment. Some decoders require you to solder a transistor between the function output and the LED. I've linked a video that covers general decoder installation, including wiring logic level only function outputs, on the screen. That's it for today. Let me know in the comments if this tutorial was helpful to you or if you have any questions.